Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. On this video, we are adding fractions that have different denominators, but we're also working with negative numbers, and so we do the following three problems on this video. All right, here's a problem. We're adding fractions that have different denominators. And we're also adding a negative and a positive number. So we have to use the rules for adding positive and negative numbers. And we also have to use the rules for adding fractions, which is we need a common denominator. So the first thing is to determine the common denominator of 6 and 8. And there are a variety of ways you could do that. I like this little method where I just say what goes into both 6 and 8, and there's a 2. 2 goes into 6 3 times, and 2 goes into 8 4, and then you could just multiply across. It's either 6 times 4 or 8 times 3. So the least common denominator is 24. But you could use any method you want for figuring out the least common denominator. So I need to write each of these fractions with a common denominator. So I have negative 3 eighths, and what I'm going to do is write that negative 3 in the numerator to make it clear. And I have to figure out what to multiply numerator and denominator by here. And 1/6 I need to multiply by something to get a common denominator of 24. All right, so for 8, using this little method, it tells you to multiply by 3, and I think most of us know 8 times 3 is 24. So I need to multiply the first fraction by 3 over 3, and to get a 24 in the second fraction, I've got to multiply the 6 times 4 to get 24 in the denominator. So I need to multiply this fraction by 4 over 4. So that's the first step, get a common denominator. So what do I have? In the numerator here, I've got negative 3 times 3, so that's negative 9 24ths plus 4 24ths. So my first step was to get a common denominator. After I get a common denominator, I'm going to use my rule for adding fractions. You write the denominator down and add the numerators. All right, so what are the numerators? Negative 9 plus 4. So my answer is negative 5 24ths, because there's more negatives than positive, right? When you're adding different signs, you take their difference. And so there we are. We've done negative 3 eighths plus 1/6. Here's our second problem. We want to do negative 1/6 plus negative 4/9. So try this on your own. You're going to have to get a common denominator first and then finish doing the problem. Okay, so what's the common denominator for 6 and 9? Hopefully most of you know that, but I could show you one way to get the answer. You see what number goes into 3, 6 and 9? 3. 3 goes into 6 twice, 3 goes into 9 3 times. This little method I use works if you only have two denominators. So I have 6 times 3 or 9 times 2, it's going to be 18ths. Right, so in the I think we need a little space here. That's going to be the next step. So first I want to write negative 1/6 times something to get 18ths, and negative 4/9 times something to get 18ths. So I decide I need to multiply the denominator here by 3 to get 18 in the denominator, so I have to multiply the numerator also by 3. And in the second fraction, I'm going to have to multiply the 9 times 2, so the numerator gets multiplied by 2. So therefore, this becomes a negative 3 eighteenths, and this becomes a negative 8 eighteenths. So first step, get a common denominator. Next step, we're adding fractions, and when you add fractions, you write the denominator down and add the numerators. So our numerators are negative 3 and negative 8, so when we add those two, we get negative 11. So you could write your answer like that, or you could just put the minus sign out in front to get negative 11 eighteenths. All right, here's our next example. We're adding three fractions. They all have unlike denominators, so we need to find the least common denominator of 5, 10, and 15. All right, this time what I'm going to do is by prime factoring the denominators. So 3/5, 5 that is already prime factored, right? And for negative 1/10, I'm going to write that as 2 times 5. And for 2/15, I'm going to write the denominator as 3 times 5. So the least common denominator is going to be what? Well, I need to have a 5 for this denominator, and I need a 2 in it from there. And I also need, so I have a 2 times a 5, and I also need a 3 times a 5. I already have the 5, and I also need a 3. So the least common denominator is 2, 5 times 2 times 3, which is 30. Okay? So my least common denominator is going to be 30, and I'm sure that some of you could get that without too much trouble or using some other method. So the question is, what can I multiply each of these by? And remember, the factored form was 2 times 3 times 5, so what I'm missing in this first one is the 3 times, I'm sorry, the 2 times 3. Which is just 6, right? You could either write 6 over 6 or 2 times 3 over 2 times 3, but basically you need to multiply the numerator and denominator by the same thing. Second fraction. All right, you're missing a 3, right? That'll give you a 30, so I have to multiply numerator and denominator by 3. And denominator of the last fraction, I've got 15 so far, I need to multiply by 2 over 2. So they all have a common denominator of 30. So in the numerator here of the first fraction, then I've got negative 3 times 6 or negative 18. Second fraction, negative 1 times 3, which is negative 3. Third fraction, 2 times 2, which is 4. So now I've got a common denominator. I get to add the numerators. All right, so I'm going to add negative 18 plus negative 3 plus 4. All right, so what's that? Well, negative 18 plus negative 3 is negative 21. And then I'm adding 4 to that. Now I'm adding a negative and a positive, so you take their difference, right? And then the sign of the larger is the negative 17. So finally, get the answer. So we're using our rules for how to add fractions, but we also have to pay attention to all the negative signs and how to deal with adding positive and negative numbers and multiplying with positive and negative numbers. For instance, here, why do negative 1 times 3? We have to remember to put the negative 3. So we're using a lot of concepts in that one problem. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.